One important feature that you need to see related to the PMTs is the power of the PMTs to collect light information anywhere along this spectrum. I've turned off the FITC laser and the PMT, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on the UV laser. So you'll see a line generated down here around 405. So I'll turn that on. You see the 405 line being generated, and now I can activate this PMT, and now you see the gray area indicating that the PMT is going to select information from that region of the spectrum. I can narrow this PMT or I can lengthen it. Let's leave it narrow for a second. We'll click on live and look over here, and you can see not a lot of information on my top window. Again, I have two PMTs engaged. So the top window is PMT1, this is PMT2, and that's the composite. Let's turn off the composite image for a second. And so you see two windows. Now I'm going to come up to this window and I'm going to increase the sensitivity of the PMT, and you will see illumination from our specimen over here. So let's concentrate on the left monitor for a second. I'm going to grab the PMT and stretch it out, and now you can see how much light enters this window from that region of the spectrum that we're just collecting from PMT number one. So the photomultiplier tubes are very powerful in increasing the illumination of your image in areas of the spectrum that maybe you're not looking at based on what the manufacturer tells you about the fluorophore. So always be aware that you can activate any one of these laser lines and turn on the PMTs and find information in that area of the spectrum. So remember, just because a manufacturer gives you a suggested excitation line for their fluorophore or a suggested emission curve for their fluorophore, you have to think outside the box a little bit, and you can go find light information or photons in area of the spectrum that maybe the manufacturer has not recommended. That's the power of these sliding photomultiplier tubes. So we'll look back at this, and you'll see again on the left screen, we have the photomultiplier tube stretched out in an area of the spectrum that's being excited by this 405 line. And then, of course, the TRITSI PMT is looking here. If we concentrate on the composite image on the right-hand side, you see a beautiful representation now of the light being emitted as a result of the excitation by the 405 line and the light being emitted and collected as a result of the TRITSI line. So again, think outside the box. Use the tools that are available to you in this software so that you can stretch out into areas of the spectrum where you might not expect to see light, but it might actually be produced there.